Now, we know that incontinence can affect women throughout their life. Yep. And we talked in the last episode specifically about pregnancy and after childbirth. Mm-hmm. What is the connection here between that and menopause specifically?
Well, the problem is with reaching menopause and the perimenopause is when we lose estrogen, that affects the pelvic floor, the large muscle that runs right under the undercarriage between the pubic bone and the tail, mm-hmm. tailbone. And that supports all our pelvic organs, the vagina, the bladder. And when we lose estrogen, these organs have estrogen receptors all over. And it's incredibly important, estrogen in that area, because it helps the strength of the muscles, the collagen input, the lining of the vagina, the strength of the muscles, the tone of the muscles. So losing estrogen, which is what happens in the perimenopause and the menopause, causes a weakness in this area.
Isn't that fascinating? So should women be seeing bladder weakness just as a normal sign of aging? Or is it something
No, I mean, it happens with age, but it's not normal.
Right.
We don't need to put up with it. We must not put up with it because it's so easy to treat in many cases for many women. Yeah. It's fairly simple things like pelvic floor exercises from a good pelvic floor physiotherapist, mm-hmm. some local estrogen can really help the majority of women.
So if we start using vaginal estrogen and doing our pelvic floor exercises, how long roughly would you say we can expect to see a difference?
Well, I think for a straightforward case, within 3 months, mm-hmm. you should notice some difference and quite dramatic differences. It does depend on the individual and the underlying cause. For example, if they have a chronic cough or if someone's carrying a bit too much weight, that will fight against the pelvic floor rehabilitation and the estrogen. Yeah. So it is about individual cases, but often within 3 months you can see
So in terms of stress incontinence, within what we're saying, 12 weeks using the localized estrogen and doing your pelvic floor exercises together, you're going to get a dramatic difference, and you may not then be.
I've seen within 3 months some people have got much better from that. But the key is some people just do pelvic floor exercises or some people just give estrogen on its own. It's the things together. That's the important thing is using both together because that will speed things up.
And getting into the habit.
Yeah, exactly.